Welcome to Learnpedia. Score more and rank better in JEE and NEET. Let's see if you can answer this actual JEE question. If you think you got the answer, then post it in the comment section below. To know the best way to answer this question, continue watching this video.
So first of all, let us write some equation for the linear SHM. As here, you can see that for a particle to perform a simple harmonic oscillation, the condition is that force acting on the particle must be proportional to its displacement from a fixed position and opposite to it. Okay, where k is a positive constant, which is force constant, and it is a characteristic of the system. So force acting on SHM, a particle performing simple harmonic oscillation, force acting is proportional to the displacement and is always opposite to it. That means if the particle is at x equal to 0, which is essentially the mean position of the particle, at that time force acting on this particle remains 0. So mean position is basically equilibrium position. Mean position is basically equilibrium position where net force acting on the particle becomes 0. But when it moves away from the mean position, for example, here it is x-axis. So it moves away from mean position, say by a distance x, then force acting on it is proportional to x and opposite to the displacement. So force acts this way, and when particle is on this side, then force acts this way. That is why such kind of forces are called restoring forces, because these forces are always trying to restore the position of the particle in the mean position, which is the most comfortable position for the particle, where its potential energy remains minimum, net force is zero, so particle can remain at peace at the mean position. So this restoring force is always trying to do that, but the oscillation will keep on going as long as the energy is there. But in case of simple harmonic motion, since it is idealized assumption, so there is no loss of energy, so simple harmonic motion will keep go on for a long time, means up to infinity. It should never stop according to the theory. So here x is the displacement from mean position. So acceleration f is equal to mass into acceleration is equal to minus kx. So in case of acceleration, we can write it by the second derivative of the displacement. That is something which we are very much aware of. So this is the equation which can be written as d2x over dt2 plus k by m into x equal to 0. So this is the equation which the particle must follow in case it is performing simple harmonic motion. X is the displacement of the particle. So displacement of the particle must follow this particular equation. That is must requirement. And here in this equation, as you can see that what is happening here, that x is such kind of a function, if we differentiate it twice, then we get something, the same function x again with some constants. Means you can see that d2x over dt2 is minus k by m into x. That means on differentiating the x twice, we get back the same function but with a negative sign and some maybe constants. So by seeing this thing, we can guess easily that there are two functions, sine and cos functions, which can do that. Because if you differentiate sine function once, you will get cos, and if you differentiate cos, you'll get back sine with minus sine. All right. And in case of cos function, if you differentiate it once, you get minus sine, and then again differentiate, you'll get minus cos. So both the functions can qualify this particular condition. Or in general, what I would say, that just assume that x is written in this form, x is equal to a sine omega t plus some kind of a angle in radian. Suppose we write x in this form, then what will be the scene, just differentiate x once. So dx by dt, which is basically the velocity of the particle. So dx by dt is what? A omega cos omega t plus phi. All right. And if we differentiate it again, means differentiate the velocity dv by dt, which is basically the second derivative of the displacement. In that case, it becomes minus omega square a, and cos again becomes sine omega t plus phi, like that. So it becomes this. So here you can clearly see that a is equal to minus omega square x, because here you have got a sine omega t plus phi back, which is nothing but x. So a is omega square x, minus omega square x, or you can say that a means the second derivative of x, so d2x over dt2, and plus, you can write it like that, omega square x is equal to 0. So this particular equation will be exactly this if omega is under root k by m. Can you see that? We have assumed x equal to a sine omega t plus phi. And here it is said that if suppose omega is under root k by m, then x is going to satisfy this particular equation, because we have written x in this form. As you can see that these two equations are same if omega is under root k by m. Or in other words, we can say that if we differentiate x twice, then we can see that in place of omega, if it is under root k by m, then this particular x will be the solution to this differential equation. So by now we have got to know that this is our solution to the simple harmonic motion. So what is simple harmonic motion? Simple harmonic motion means the displacement x of the particle must satisfy this equation, this differential equation, d2x over dt2 plus k by m into x equal to 0. Or finally, we can say that we have found the solution. X is equal to a sine omega t plus phi is solution to this equation, provided omega is under root k by m. So this is the equation. Omega is under root k by m. So if displacement of the particle satisfies this relation, then the particle is performing simple harmonic motion. Or you can say that if we differentiate this equation, we get v is equal to a omega cos omega t plus phi. So this is the velocity. If some particle is moving in such a way that its velocity can be represented by this, then that particle must be performing simple harmonic oscillation. And similarly, we can differentiate this to get the acceleration back. It will be minus omega square x. Okay. If we differentiate this again a, then it becomes what? Minus omega square a sine omega t plus phi.
Hey there. Hope you understood the concept. Here's the answer to the question that was asked in the beginning. Keep watching to give an edge to your JEE and NEET preparation. LearnMedia's JEE and NEET prep tools contain over 4,000 videos and over 20,000 questions. You can access them online through our website or offline through an SD card or a pen drive. To buy now, visit www.learnpedia.in. You can also try a free demo of the product before buying.